Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to a brand new episode of König & Bauer Live. It's the second week, but it's the first day live from König & Bauer Sheetfed here in Radebeul. We're talking about digitalization. It's a hard word for a German guy. I'm really, really glad to introduce to you Ralf Sammeck. He is the CEO of König & Bauer Sheetfed and brand new CDO of König & Bauer. Hi, Ralf. Nice to meet you.
Sven, thank you very much. Yeah, it's an exciting day for us, and we are so happy that you take your time to see us here. And digitalization is extremely important for us. And you mentioned my additional job, so I had a lot to do prior to that. But as you know, I really like digitalization. Why? Because with digitalization and big data, we can support our customers much, much better and make our customers even more successful. And that is the reason why we really live digitalization here at König & Bauer. And yes, and I'm very excited that we have today the option to show it to you, not only with my little speech here, also that you get an idea what we can offer. And for us, it's most important that we can provide you with additional information and additional services that you can run your business even more professional. And therefore, we have many offerings we would like to show you. And also, we also want to show you that with our new hotline, we can provide you even better, not only for technical issues, also for printing issues. We have a big team available for you 24/7, also with visual press support, so we can show you exactly what to do to fix the machine, and most often we don't even have to come. So these are many new service offerings, but also for us important is with our customer portal, you are able to get performance reports, you can do benchmarking, and all these services is available for you. And of course, we can help you also to analyze everything, and therefore, we will work even closer together in the next future to be more successful. And therefore, I'm very excited to give you a first peek what is possible and how we can support your business. I'm very excited, and I hope you will be too. Thank you very much. Sven?
Thanks, Ralf. We're going in detail a little bit later. There's just one more question that's really on my mind. When becoming CDO as a CEO, did your life change?
To be honest, not really, because I have a digital mind, and therefore also my colleagues told me, Ralf, you would be the right person for this job. And I immediately agreed on it, because I really think with digitalization, we can help our customers so much more. And I'm really looking forward to do this together with our customers, because our goal, of course, is König & Bauer customers, they have to be the most successful companies in our industry.
So your life didn't really change, but I'm really pretty sure about that our life will change due to that. Thank you very much, Ralf. Whatever can be digitalized will be digitalized. We heard that very often, ladies and gentlemen. But now we want to talk about what already is digitalized here at König & Bauer in this episode of König & Bauer Live. Thomas Göcke is with me now. He is responsible for the digital transformation here at König & Bauer Sheetfed. Thomas, great to meet you again.
Sven, my very special pleasure, though I have to say, I think we all planned to be a little bit differently, right?
Yeah, we are here now. Normally, we would be at Drupa at Düsseldorf, but Corona changed everything. The whole world and whole industries were paralyzed. What happened here at König & Bauer?
Sven, literally, we definitely had no time to scratch our heads even. Immediately, we asked us three questions. What about the people? What about our community, our society? And what about König & Bauer?
Most of us had the impulse to say, okay, what can I do for the people that, I don't know, are in need in these special times? Yes. What was your idea in Corona times?
Sven, we thought we have the equipment on site, we have the people on site, why not produce face protection shields? And so we came up with the idea of producing 100,000 face protection shields.
And they look awesome. They look like that.
Yes, by purpose, Sven.
Why are they so colorful? Because it's a serious thing, the corona thing.
It is a serious thing, but we thought, you know what, we're going to donate 100,000 of these face protection shields to kindergarten, preschools, and so on. And we strongly believe that kids are scared if people run around with these medical face protection shields and masks.
All look like doctors.
Yes, exactly. And we thought, you know what, we need to make this a little bit more kids friendly. And we got overwhelming feedback on this. Kids really love it, people love it. So I think it was the right approach. We donated and shipped around the world. And around the world really means around the world.
Okay.
I'm talking about, of course, Germany.
Sure.
I'm talking about Italy. I'm talking about Spain. I'm talking about Greece and
all the hotspots.
The hotspots and as well hospitals in the US we ship to.
Okay, great idea to help the people, but König & Bauer is the eldest printing press manufacturer in the world and you are well known for your very special customer relationship. How could you help, how could you assist your customers in these hard times?
Very fast, very soon we came up with our three-step action plan towards our customers. And the first point was, we thought, you know what, we need to support our customers in an expanded, in a better way. So we opened up our hotline, our service hotline, to 24/7 in additional service fields. We included application engineers, mechanical engineers, and we added our exciting, great, awesome video, augmented video support technology into that offering. So people love it, get in contact easily, collaborate with our customers, collaborate with König & Bauer, first step. Second one, we opened up our customer portal, our customer community, free for every user.
Mm-hmm.
And the third story was, we kind of created in close cooperation with our customers, with every specific customers, with every customer, tailor-made wear and spare parts packages, because we couldn't be sure what happens in the future on logistics chains, right?
Which border might be closed and how long?
Exactly. So we offered the opportunity to get these spare and wear parts at the time when the borders were still open, logistics chains were working. And I think this kind of proactive approach underlines our proactive approach on how we support our customers, stay productive, being able to run the business even in this kind of unprecedented times.
So Thomas, there were a lot of ideas in these very special times. The question is, do the customers like your ideas?
Sven, they loved it. I tell you, they really love it. Let's talk about the let's want to talk about the hotline and the visual press support or augmented video support system. From February to March, so in the middle of Corona times, we had an increase of 310% of the usage of the technology towards our customers. Huge numbers. Our customer community, we made the sign-up process really, really simple. Sign-up numbers went through the roof. So people love it. I think we did exactly what the market was asking for.
So good job. Last time we met, Thomas, was quite here and quite a year ago on your last open house event. And we were talking about digitalization.
Yes.
What happened at König & Bauer? What happened in Corona times? Where are we now?
Sven, we talked about digitalization. We talked about our offerings towards our customers. And as you know, we both have been on stage. Look here, that picture.
Oh, look, same shoes.
You. Same shoes, yeah. And so let's talk a little bit about industrial analytics, since this is here one of the spots.
One thing I'll never forget is a word I never heard of before last year, artificial ignorance.
Yes, Sven, everybody's talking about artificial intelligence, but we are using artificial ignorance as our method in order to separate out of the huge stream of data we're getting out of every single press on the market, the normal, and separate the normal behavior from the abnormal behavior. And then let's focus on the abnormal behavior. And we have kind of bots of looking into these different sensor messages.
So not all bots are evil in the world.
No, definitely not. Our bots are our friends, Sven.
Okay.
Our bots are our friends. We have trained them. They are specialized on certain error messages, certain patterns of error messages within the sensor stream of sensor data. And they are trained and adapted even to the specific customer application, customer press. And these kinds of bots, multiple bots per machine, create automatically service cases in our service system.
So in a digital world, everything is live, everything is online.
Yes.
Could you show me one of your cases, please?
Sven, sure. I do have my system here with me, or a view into the system here with me. Mm-hmm. What we do see here on that side, first of all, it's our service support system. Second, we see a diagram here. And that diagram does show that there's a number, a solid number of errors triggered by our bots. Mm-hmm. And these errors do show that the fan filter of the main motor is clogged. So let's have a little bit deeper look into here. Yeah. Let's zoom a little bit into kinds of a wider range. And what we do see here on the diagram, that the customer kind of did one of the maintenance too late. The first
the red line
uh-huh. exactly does show maintenance overdue, but he did it immediately after that message. But we saw that in the middle of that service interval, these errors are popping up, mm-hmm. telling us.
The yellow ones there.
The yellow ones, right, the yellow ones, telling us that the fan filter of the main motor is clogged. So what happened here, the system created automatically that case. Our service engineer was informed about that that case was assigned to him. The service engineer looked into the data, looked into the information on the system, and informed the customer about that issue. Why is that so serious? If the customer would have not cleaned the filter sooner or shorter, the main engine would have been failed.
Okay.
Serious damage, downtime, unplanned downtimes, huge cost on the customer side. So by using this technology, we have been able to proactively inform the customer, hey, you better clean up the filter, there's an issue here, in order to prevent unplanned downtime.
And when automatically?
This automatically created, of course, somebody of our service engineer called, the customer told them, hey, you have to look there and there. You did the maintenance, but probably didn't do the full maintenance, or you did something wrong, but please double check the fan filter. And then of course our customer service expert was behind that, and mm-hmm. if we go deeper again into the system, mm-hmm. we do see that on March 24th the fan filter was cleaned by the customers, and that's exactly what the numbers do show, that after March 23rd the errors disappeared.
No yellow anymore,
customer happy, unplanned downtimes prevented.
Regarding to customer happy, how can your customers get this industrial analytics?
good question, Sven. The good story here is every of our customers is getting this support system with a new contract or with a new contract for a new press.
Uh-huh.
Second, if customers are out of warranty, of course they can sign up for this service once they are signing up for a full service contract. So this is part of our service offerings towards our customers for new machines and customers with a full service contract. Great story.
If you want to see more information on that or more cases, just watch out for König & Bauer 360 or hashtag König & Bauer 360 in all the usual social media platforms and
yes.
on the web. Well, okay, so last year when we were standing here, we were also talking about the customer community you invented. What did happen there to Corona maybe?
That is correct. So due to Corona, of course, we saw, and I think I mentioned that, we saw a huge increase of numbers of customers signing up for the customer community. So I think we have been provided that service at the right time. So mm-hmm. because our customer community enables and eases the way of communication between our customers and us, and gives them insight about the production, the performance of the press.
And in the end, a feeling of togetherness in these times. Huh?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Social distancing, but getting together.
Yes.
On your community.
Streamlined processes, yes, and so on. But as well, I promised last year when we have been on stage together that we're going to ask our customers what do they want to see next as part of the customer community. And the overwhelming feedback was, we want to see an increased and improved reporting within that customer community. So we came up with the idea and the concept and the product of Performance Analytics Plus, which will be a substantial part of our customer community. And the Performance Analytics Plus package will provide the press operator, the print production manager, the plant manager, or even the management of the company with trend analytics, OEE, cockpits, and so on, giving really inside information what's going on the press and helps them, for instance, to plan or to do the production planning meetings for the next or for the upcoming days.
How's that going to look like?
Sven, I have something for you here. First concept, first idea of that. This is how we going to probably launch the first version of our Performance Analytics Plus dashboard functionality, OE cockpit as mentioned. And the good story is it's not just a static dashboard, but customers can modify, can tweak it to their needs.
Customers can customize.
Absolutely, yes.
Great.
Because we listen to our customers, right? What's the need?
Absolutely. And when will Performance Analytics Plus be available for the customers?
Sven, we are always fast. Performance Analytics Plus will be available for the first customers in the second half of the year 2020.
So looking about forward. 14 days.
Yes.
Great. Thomas, thanks a lot for all the information for now.
Sure.
I'm looking forward to see you next year on Drupa in April 2021 or on your next open house.
Me too.
Here at König & Bauer. Ladies and gentlemen, thanks a lot for watching König & Bauer Live. Stay tuned, come back tomorrow. Same spot, different content. We will show you machines running, we will show you whole production processes, and we will be here the next 3 days for you. So thank you for watching and stay tuned.